Full battery.
Hi, my name is Yihan.
My name is Victor Jet. I'm basically doing the simulation for our doing some testing.
Hi, my name is Jimmy. I'm the safety manager.
So this is basically an outline of what we're going to be going over. So the background, fuel cells, those are the objectives, our requirements for our project, some our timeline that's been updated based on our progress so far, also our progress, the budget that we have, resources, and then our starting rate. Yeah. So a little bit of background on fuel cells. So why should we be pursuing them? So this is a plot of basically fossil fuel reserves that we have, and then the production obviously it's sort of plateauing, as you can see, and then the reserves that we currently have are declining very fast, and expected in the future that if we reserve heavily on fossil fuels, we're not really going to have a sustainable energy source. From the far left, you can see sort of the greenhouse gas emissions, which contributes to air pollution, global warming, and then just overall bad quality of gas, which affects people's health. So one of the reasons why we'd like to pursue fuel cells instead is that they're basically a emission-free energy producing device. So basically what they do is they take an oxidizer and a fuel. In our case, the fuel will be oxygen for a proton exchange membrane fuel cell. Oxygen, you can be, as long as it contains oxygen, that's fine. So in our case, we'll be using air. Can basically, by setting up the fuel cell, you can generate electricity from having the fuel oxidizer.
For some of the goals, we're following the Department of Energy 2020 targets, which is maintaining a 0.8 volts, 300 milliamps per centimeter squared. And we're trying also to achieve a linear density of 1.5 amps per centimeter squared. Some of our requirements, we have three sub-teams, which is the systems team, the modeling and simulation, and the testing team. For the systems, for our porous media, we're trying to have a porosity of greater than 85%. And then also for the tubing insulation, to have a relative humidity of less than 1%. Modeling, we're trying to achieve, for the heating pad, to heat the fuel cell from 20 degrees to 80 degrees Celsius within 10 minutes, and also to generate a model for the polarization curve to be 15% of the test data points. And lastly, for testing, to operate at 80 degrees Celsius for our test stand, and also to have the torque compression ratio for the gas diffusion layer, which is also known as GDL, and have the max lean torque of our open circuit voltage to be greater than 0.9 volts.
So timeline, this is basically adjusted for our budget. So originally what we planned was to have the fuel cell being manufactured and finished by the end of fall quarter. There are some delays with manufacturing and purchasing and designing some of the parts. So right now we're in the final stages of assembling the fuel cell, and then we hope to achieve these specs for our fuel cell by the end of winter. Plus just a 0.6 volt of an output, 300 milliamps per centimeter squared. And then last spring we have a sort of intermediate goal, which is in between the goal we hope to achieve by the end of winter and the final project goal. But the main one we hope to achieve is the 0.8 volts at 300 milliamps squared. So far.
So we've actually manufactured our bipolar plate. Last year we had it, but dimensions and the tolerance wasn't right. So this year, this actually starting last quarter, we modeled our bipolar plate and ordered the necessary parts. This quarter we actually assembled the bipolar plates. We don't have the we got the PM material, porous media material last week, so we're planning to integrate that into the system probably this week or next week. But this is our current design for the bipolar. For the simulation, this is the most up-to-date simulation. Last quarter, we had the cross-media simulation, but this one is actually more accurate, and we compare our data to Professor Wang's, who's our advisor, and did the error analysis for two different cases where the humidity ratio is 0.25, for 0.25 and 0.42, and we found out that the error is still around 10% for each, but this is a great improvement from last quarter, and we still look forward to improve our model.
It is the customized test that we design for in fuel cell testing. So why we want design this? Because the testing you take like a couple hours, so we want something to hold it, and usually operating in very high temperature since we're heating it up. So the simulations was done under 2 pounds load, which is the weight of our fuel cell, and 80 degrees Celsius, which is the operating temperatures for our fuel cell testing. For the heating simulations, the heating requirement for our goal is to heating up the temperatures of the inner surface of the biopolar plate from 20 degrees Celsius, which is the room temperatures, to 80 degrees Celsius within 50 minutes. So the minimum heating powers to meet our requirement based on simulations is like is the 30 watts based on the SolidWorks thermal simulations. And the BO number was determined as the 0.006 under the our heat operating heating condition.
So for the budget, the total budget is $3,000 for the fuel cell, and for the bipolar plate plus the labor is like $390. And we bought 15 MEAs, it costs $900. And the gaskets, there are 4 different kinds of gaskets, and it's about $88. So for now, we have $1,621 for total. And for the resource, here's the chart for how many units and how many hours we are taking right now. And we can get some resources from the Renewable Energy Resources Laboratory and the National Fuel Cell Research Center.
And then here's our sub-team breakdown. Our advisor, Professor Yin Wang. Currently, myself and Chris are teammates. We have 3 managers. Then, as you can see, those are our sub-team breakdowns, systems teams, modeling, testing, and then we have at least 3 members in each team. And then these are just some of the changes that we made to slides earlier. That is it for our project.
Time for a couple questions.